Hello everyone. สวัสดีค่ะ You're with me, teacher Tisha. I'm going to teach you about how to do IELTS examination. This part is listening. I'm going to teach you how to connect between what you see. That means what you see in the paper, in the exam, and what you hear. It is listening skill, and I'm going to use math science concept. Its name System Thinking and Cybernetics. Please enjoy the video.
So, welcome to your introductory geography lecture. We'll begin with some basics. Firstly, what do we learn by studying geography? Well, we learn a great deal about all the processes that have affected and that continue to affect the Earth's surface. But we learn far more than that, because studying geography also informs us about the different kinds of relationships that develop between a particular environment and the people that live there. Okay, we like to think of geography as having two main branches. There's the study of the nature of our planet, its physical features, what it actually looks like, and then there's the study of the ways in which we choose to live and of the impact of those on our planet. Our current use of carbon fuels is a good example of that. But there are more specific study areas to consider too, and we'll be looking at each of these in turn throughout the semester. These include biophysical geography, by which I mean the study of the natural environment and all its living things. Then there's topography. That looks at the shapes of the land and oceans. There's the study of political geography and social geography too, of course, which is the study of communities of people. We have economic geography, in which we examine all kinds of resources and their use, agriculture, for example. Next comes historical geography, the understanding of how people and their environments and the ways they interact have changed over a period of time. And urban geography, an aspect I'm particularly interested in, which takes as its focus the location of cities, the services that those cities provide, and migration of people to and from such cities. And lastly, we have cartography. That's the art and science of map making. You'll be doing a lot of that. So, to summarise before we continue, we now have our key answer. Studying this subject is important because without geographical knowledge, we would know very little about our surroundings and we wouldn't be able to identify all the problems that relate to them. So, by definition, we wouldn't be in an informed position to work out how to solve any of them. Okay, now for some practicalities. What do geographers actually do? Well, we collect data to begin with. You'll be doing a lot of that on your first field trip. How do we do this? There are several means. We might, for example, conduct a census, count a population in a given area, perhaps. We also need images of the Earth's surface, which we can produce by means of computer generation technology or with the help of satellite relays. We've come a very long way from the early exploration of the world by sailing ships, when geographers only had pens and paper at their disposal. After we've gathered our information, we must analyse it. We need to look for patterns, most commonly those of causes and consequences. This kind of information helps us to predict and resolve problems that could affect the world we live in. But we don't keep all this information confidential. We then need to publish our findings so that other people can access it and be informed by it. And one way in which this information can be published is in the form of maps. You'll all have used one at some stage of your life already. Let's consider the benefits of maps from a geographer's perspective. Maps can be folded and put in a pocket and can provide a great store of reference when they're collected into an atlas. They can depict the physical features of the entire planet if necessary, or just a small part of it in much greater detail. But there is a drawback. You can't exactly replicate something that is three-dimensional, like our planet, on a flat piece of paper, because paper has only two dimensions. and that means there'll always be a certain degree of distortion on a map. It can't be avoided. We can also use aerial photographs, pictures taken by cameras at high altitude above the Earth. These are great for showing all kinds of geographical features that are not easy to see from the ground. You can easily illustrate areas of diseased trees or how much traffic is on the roads at a given time, or information about deep sea beds, for example. Then there are Landsats. These are satellites that circle the Earth and transmit visual information to computers at receiving stations. They circle the Earth several times a day and can provide a mass of information. You'll all be familiar with the information they give us about the weather, for example. So, what we're going to do now is look at a short presentation in which you'll see all these tools.
Okay, everyone, can you do it? Alright. Okay, let me tell you something. What I'm going to show you right now, I'm going to match. Again, I'm going to use system thinking and cybernetics to analyze the question. Cybernetics. What I'm going to do, I'm going to match between what you hear from here, what you hear, like that from the record, what you hear, and match them with what you see. What you see is like in the paper, like the question here. So you're going to use both skill, like you're going to use both what you see, how to read the question quickly, how to organize them, how to link them with what you hear from the audio. Okay. ก็เดี๋ยวแปลไทยให้นะคะนิดนึงนะคะ but if you're not Thai whatever with nationality you are you just follow me step by step but I'm going to speak in Thai a little bit to explain in case that some people who listen to this video who watch the video are Thai ครูก็จะลิงระหว่างการที่เราได้ยินคือได้ยินจากเทป record ใช่ไหมคะกับสิ่งที่เราเห็นสิ่งที่เราเห็นด้วยตาวิชวลก็คือเราอ่านคำถามในนี้มันเป็นการลิงก์แบบ two skill two ทักษะสองทักษะเข้าด้วยกันแล้วคุณจะใช้ system thinking and cybernetics link ทางลิงก์ยังไงคุณจะลิงก์ว่าสิ่งที่เราได้ยินเป็นอย่างไรคุณจะเขียนด้วยหมึกเอาว่าสิ่งที่เราได้ยินคุณจะเขียนด้วยประมาณหมึกสีฟ้าแล้วก็คำตอบเอาเป็นสีแดงก็แล้วกันโอเคนะคะSo I'm going to link them. I'm going to write what you hear on the blue with the blue color, and then how to write. And I'm going to write the answer with the red one. This technique is system thinking and cybernetics. It is a math science. Like we call my background is science. Okay. Let's listen to them step by step together, huh?They talk about geography, like a Pumisan. Okay? Alright, let's do it again. They give you some time to read number 31 to 40. Okay. Let's see.
Now listen carefully and answer questions 31 to 40.So, welcome to your introductory geography lecture. We'll begin with some basics.
This is your geography lecture here. So, we come up to this part. Okay.
Firstly, what do we learn by studying geography? Well, we learn a great deal about all the processes that have affected and that continue to affect the Earth's surface.
Okay, can you hear this word? They said that...affected and that continue to affect to the earth. What is earth? Earth what?
By studying geography. Well, we learn a great deal about all the processes that have affected and that continue to affect the earth's surface.
The earth's surface. So that means you have to link between that they continue affect like a different person. Yes, you see the effects of differentprocess on the earth they in the tablet card you hear the earth's surface but
When you see it, when you read the question, they say dot 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 of the earth. So you have to put the word surface, comma. Again, let me explain in Thai. น้องได้ยินคำว่า continue affect the earth surface yeah, for the record. แต่ว่าเวลาเราอ่านโจทย์ the effect of different processes on the dot 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 of the earth. So that means earth surface, you have to see something like associate it.กับคำว่า surface ค่ะที่แปลว่าพื้นผิวโลก Okay, let's do the next one.
But we learn far more than that, because studying geography also informs us about the different kinds of relationships that develop between a particular environment and the people that live
there. That develop between the...
Okay, we like to think of relationships that develop between a particular environment and
Develop between the particular environment that what you hear on radar with the blue color. Loading, come on. Develop between a particular. แต่เวลาทำสอบไม่ต้องเขียนแบบนี้นะคะอันนี้เขียนให้ดูเพื่อให้เข้าใจเวลาทำสอบใส่คำตอบเลย Particular environmentEnvironment นี่คือคำที่ได้ยินใช่ไหมคะ Environment And the people that live there แต่เขาไม่ใช้คำว่า population ที่แปลว่าประชากรเขาพูดคำว่า population คือ Okay when titling between what we hear and what we readI will write out in blue and green for what we hear from the tape record. You hear that the word that they develop between a particular environment and the people that live there. People that live there refer to population.Okay, now we go next, we get the answer 31, 32. Now we go next to number 33.
People that live there. Okay, we like to think of geography as having two main branches.
Two main branches. Yeah, two main branches. Physical features and human lifestyle and that. Dot, dot, dot.
There's the study of the nature of our planet, its physical features, what it actually looks like,And then there's the study of the way...
Okay, you hear this word physical features, and then in the tape record, they say that actually looks like. That refer to physical features.
In which we choose to live, and of the impact of those on our planet.
Can you hear this one? They said like we choose to live, yeah? From the tape record, they hear we...Choose to live. This one you have to associate. We choose to live, associate with human lifestyle. And, okay, see, I use system thinking. And then.
Our current use of carbon, what it actually looks like. And then there's the study of the ways in which we choose to live and of the impact of those on our planet.
An impact of those.On our planet. So you can hear the word impact. Impact. Yeah, they said that we should live and of the impact of dirt on our planet. Okay, go to the next one really quick. Oops. Let's see the next one.We're going to find out number 34, specific study area. They tell you this one very interesting. น่าสนใจมากเลยค่ะคือเขาจะบอก geography 2แบบใหญ่ๆ They're going to tell you more two kinds of geography. What you're going to hear from the tape record. You're going to hear similar lighting. Historical geography.And then they're going to explain, oh, what are they, blah, 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 blah. And number two, you're going to hear this word, dot, 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 geography. And you have to find out what is this word,
Can you see the pattern? There have two of them, historical and geography.
ภาษาไทยอินไทยแลนด์แปลหมายความว่าเขาจะบอก geography ภูมิศาสตร์สองแบบมันเป็น pattern บอกคำแรก historical you try to listen ฟังให้ดีว่าคำว่า historical อยู่ไหนแล้วเขาก็จะ explain historical คืออะไรหลังจากนั้นก็จะมี geography อีกแบบหนึ่ง okay you have to listen that is the main point how to get full mark from this part okay like here
our current use of carbon fuels is a good example of that But there are more specific study areas to consider too, and we'll be looking at each of these in turn throughout the semester. These include biophysical geography, by which I mean the study of the natural environment and all its living things. Then there's topography. That looks at the shapes of the land and oceans. There's the study of political geography and social geography too, of course, which is the study of communities of people.We have economic geography, in which we examine all kinds of resources and their use, agriculture, for example. Next comes historical geography, the understanding of how people and their environments and the ways they interact have changed over a period of time. And urban geography, an aspect I'm particularly interested in, which takes as its focus...The location of cities, the services that those cities provide.
Okay, so you can choose here, that's what is urban geography, and then they say that what are urban geography about? This one, you say urban. Urban คือในเมืองใช่ไหมคะ?
And migration of people to and from such city.
Okay, they say that urban geography is focused on location of city. I mean location of cities.And then the next one, service. So service. And then they say about, did you hear the word migration? Migration means that opayo behind thin hand, okay? Anyway, next.
And lastly, we have cartography.
And lastly, we have cartography. If you don't know about cartography, I give you vocabulary very quick. Cartography is the study of shape, feature of the Earth and other planet. So that means study of shape. Study of shape and features.Of the earth, I use E, and other planet, I use P. Let's go, Nate, what are you going to hear next?
That's the art and science of map making. You'll be doing a lot of that. So, to summarize...
To summarize, it's come to 35 now.
Before we continue, we now have our key answer.
You're going to hear the word. Now I use a purple color for the audio record that you hear. You're going to hear key. You didn't hear key point, but you're going to hear there are different words. What are they? Key answers. So that means you come up in here in this question, number 35 already.Yes, number 35. Some student, คือบางเรื่องบางคนหลงทางอะไปข้อ35เราอยู่32ประมาณนี้ You might lost the way but now you use my technique system thinking and cybernetic math science เชื่อครูได้เพราะครูได้ปอโทครูได้คะแนน statistics วิชาเกี่ยวกับ math ได้เต็มเนาะก็ครูคือ math science ในการ help you อะค่ะโอเคไปต่อ35 let's go
Studying this subject is important because without geographical knowledge, we would know very little about our surroundings and we wouldn't be able to identify all the...
Okay, they talk about surrounding already and identify...
...problems that relate to them.
Okay, what did you hear from the record? Let's hear again together, quick.
...important because without geographical knowledge, we would know very little about our surroundings...
We would know very little about our surrounding.
And we wouldn't be able to identify all...
And we wouldn't be able to identify...
All the problems that relate to them.
Okay, you hear that one, we wouldn't be able to identify all the problem. And all the problems that relate to them. That relate to them. Okay, can you link this one that relate to? It's like a, it refers to associate. Yeah, problems that relate to them, relate to and associate here. This one link. So your answer have to be the associate surrounding and the associated problems. Here is your answer from 35 problems. That's it. Okay, will we try to do the next question? Question 36. Let's go.
So, by definition, we wouldn't be in an informed position to work out how to solve any of them.
Go to 36? No.
Okay, now for some practicalities. What do geographers actually do?
Okay, you hear this word. What do they say? What do geographers actually do? That's referred to what do geographers do?
Well, we collect data to begin with. You'll be doing a lot of that on your first field trip. How do we do this? There are several means. We might, for example, conduct a census, count a population in a given area, perhaps. We also need images of the Earth's surface, which we can produce by means of computer generation technology.
Okay, you hear this word again.
What do geographers actually do? Well, we collect data to begin with. You'll be doing a lot of that on your first field trip. How do we do this? There are several means. We might, for example, conduct a census.
Conduct a census. They are here. Conduct a census. How to conduct the censuses? You're going to hear they say that.
Count a population in a given area, perhaps.
Count a population?
We also need images of the Earth's surface.
We also need the images of...
which we can produce by means of computer generation technology.
Okay, I'm going to write for you what you hear from the tip. Very quick, but I'm writing a short one.
Perhaps. We also need images of the Earth.
They said we also need images of the Earth's surface. Oops. Of the Earth's surface. Of images. Images of dot 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 and...
surface, which we can produce by means of computer...
with the can produce more.
Generation technology.
Okay.
Or with...
they said that we can produce, you hear this word, produce by, palit kima doi by computer. Computer. Generation technology. Technology and 1X.
Help of satellite relays.
And satellite relay. And you heard this word. Satellite. Satellite mean satellite. Right in the air, this one. Satellite relay. Again, your system thinking and cybernetics math side. You link this one, computer and satellite technology. It's linked with this sentence that you hear from the audio record. This one link. What that in front of them? Images. Using by images. So your answer is very easy. Images. Images, like pictures. Go next to number 37 very quick.
We've come a very long way from the early exploration of the world by sailing ships when geographers only had pens and paper at their disposal.
Long time ago, they have just pen and paper, but at the moment, now they can use both computer and satellite technology. Go next. Okay, number 37. Analyze analyze data, identify dot dot dot. For example, e.g. You know the word e.g. E.g. come from, for example. Yeah, you know that word. For example, cause and effect. But in the audio, you will hear another word.
After we've gathered our information, we must analyze it.
No, analyze this part.
We need to look for patterns, most commonly those of causes and consequence.
We need to look for what you hear from number 37. You hear, I use from the tape record, how about we, I use blue color. You hear this one, number 37. We need to look for patterns. We need to look for patterns. Okay, and next one.
This kind of information helps us to predict.
Okay, one more time.
Geographers only had pens and paper at their disposal. After we've gathered our information,
here,
we must analyze it.
Analyze it.
We need to look for patterns, most commonly those of causes and consequences.
Yeah, you hear, but they say that most common those of, but they use different word. They use causes and consequences. Consequences. Yeah, they use causes and consequences. Why are you going to analyze? Again, causes here. But consequences, well, they say, in audio, they say consequences. แปลว่าผลที่ตามมาแปลว่า cause แปลว่าสาเหตุ effect คือผล but they use cause and consequences. You have to associate consequences with effect. Yep. So your answer have to be patterns. So analyze data, identify pattern. For example, cause and consequences or cause and effect. Okay, we almost finished. Let's do the next one together. Quick. Do number 38. Let's see number 38. Look at this one. They're going to map. Well, what is benefit? What are benefits of maps? Easy to carry. Can show physical features of large or small area, but a two-dimensional map will always have some lie. Some lie. Have to find this word, and this one quite a little bit tricky. It's not that you. It's not a normal word that we use in our life, but you can hear it. Let's go.
This kind of information helps us to predict and resolve problems that could affect the world we live in. But we don't keep all this information confidential. We then need to publish our findings so that other people can access it and be informed by it. And one way in which this information can be published is in the form of maps. You'll all have used one at some stage of your life already. Let's consider the benefits of maps from a geographer's perspective. Maps can be folded and put in a pocket, and can provide a great store of reference when they're collected into an atlas. They can depict the physical features of the entire planet if necessary, or just a small part of it in much greater detail. But there is a drawback. You can't exactly replicate something that is three-dimensional, like our planet, on a flat piece of paper, because paper has only two dimensions. And that means there'll always be a certain degree of distortion on a map. It can't be avoided.
Okay, they said that. Okay, that means there always be a certain degree of distortion on the map. This one is what you hear on the tape record. You hear this sentence. Certain degree of distortion on a map. They talk about two dimension, 2D map. It's always have some. distortion. So your answer have to be distortion. And you might don't know what does the word distortion mean. Okay, because we not often use it. Let me tell you, distortion means a change to the original. Okay, I write down the meaning for you here. Distortion means a change. A change to the original. Or natural shape of something.
Good, yeah, then we go next to number 39. Okay, if you don't know the word aerial, aerial means relate with what? Relate with what? I give you a choice. Aerial, water, soil, air, fire. Which one that the sound almost the same with aerial? Between water, soil, fire, air. Yes, have to be air, so that means relate with air, further from air. Okay, let's listen to the next one.
We can also use aerial photographs.
Come here to aerial photograph. Now we in here. For goodness.
Pictures taken by cameras at high altitude above the earth. These are great for showing all kinds of geographical features that are not easy to see from the ground. You can easily illustrate areas of diseased trees or...
Okay, you hear the word they? They write vegetable problems, but you hear the word diseased tree. D-R-S-E-A-S-E-D. Diseased. Trees. This is refer to problem. Tree is vegetation. Yeah, vegetation means trees, flower. Okay. And the next one. Oh, interesting. The one you have to find out.
How much traffic is on the roads at a given?
They said how much traffic is on the road. How much traffic? Is on the road, and then what did they say?
Time, or information about
the road at given time. And time, the road at given time refer to density. Density like a number of cars on the road per time. So your answer have to be traffic, like a traffic density. Density means ความหนาแน่นของการจราจร. Okay, traffic. Density, and the next one, interesting.
Deep seabeds, for example.
Did you hear this word? Deep seabed, that refer to ocean floor. Ocean floor, deep seabed. I teach you like really go to detail because I would like you to understand and analyze the examination. But when you go to exam, you have to do really quick that you do this technique. See that the vocabulary and sentence before and after and find the word. โอเคภาษาไทยนะคะครูเขียนรายละเอียดให้มีการฟังทุกอย่างละเอียดมากเพราะครูต้องการให้เราวิเคราะห์ analyze ได้แต่เวลาเราไปทำสอบจริงๆดูประโยคหน้าประโยคหลังดูคำที่คล้ายกันเห็นไหมเขาจะพูดเขียนอีกคำหนึ่งแต่ได้ยินอีกคำหนึ่งอย่างเช่นได้ยินคำว่า density เขาบอก given time ก็หมายถึง density หรือว่าDeep seabed หมายถึง ocean floor แต่เวลาทำจริงเราต้องทำอย่างรีบเร่งให้ทันกับเวลาเราเขียนทราฟฟิกลงไปที่สอนละเอียดเพราะต้องการให้เราคิดแต่เวลาทำจริงเราต้องรีบทำใช้เทคนิคนี้ฝึกบ่อยๆ and then we go to the last one
then there are Landsats these are satellites that circle the earth and transmit visual information to computers at receiving stations they circle the earth several times a day and can provide a mass of informationYou'll all be familiar with the information they give us about the weather, for example.
You say that you're going to hear like they give us about their weather. So your answer, weather. For example. Alright, that's it for today.
I hope you liked the video clip, and now you know how to get full mark in some parts of the examination.
Please feel free to follow me on social media, Facebook, Instagram, or YouTube channel. แค่ก็กดไลค์กดตามได้นะคะใน Facebook นะคะหรือว่า Instagram หรือว่าในช่อง YouTube ค่ะ Thank you very much สวัสดีค่ะ Bye